back to a proverb a day keeps foolishness away. It's day 5, and today's proverb is in Proverbs chapter 5, verse 18. It says, "May your fountain be blessed, and may you rejoice in the wife of your youth, a loving doe, a graceful deer. May her breasts satisfy you always, and may you be intoxicated with her love." Again, this is a father speaking to his son. I'm sure if he was speaking to his daughter, it would have sounded something else, sounded like something else. And it's clear that this scripture or this proverb is talking about sex or lovemaking. It's talking about him paying attention and admiring and enjoying and finding satisfaction in his wife, her body and her physical appearance, everything about her. He says, be intoxicated by her love. Let her breasts satisfy you. It means it's calling the attention of husbands to be content or satisfied with what they already have. Okay, the preceding verses said that, let me read it. Drink water from your own cistern or from your own well. Share your love only with your wife. Why spill water of your spring in the streets, having sex with just anyone? The two proverbs away, I talked a little bit about being faithful to your spouse. You know, I know that staying faithful and being loyal to each other in the marriage covenant is not just about sex, having sex with one person. There are other ways that people can be unfaithful, but in this verse of scripture, it's talking about sex and lovemaking in marriage, and it's encouraging spouses to enjoy what they have, be satisfied, be intoxicated with her love, the wife of your youth, the husband of your youth. Okay, so it's just bringing to our remembrance or calling our attention again to the vow that says, forsaking all others. You have chosen this one. And so you need to every day make it a point of duty to prioritize one another, prioritize sex, prioritize making love to your spouse. Don't do it just once in a blue moon. Okay, you need to find satisfaction in each other. Okay, and then since you chose this one, even though you had the opportunity to choose among millions of people that you have met in your lifetime, you decided to be with this man or this woman. God's wisdom to you today is that you choose again to stick with this person. Whether she's growing fat and the breasts are falling, the father spoke to the son and said, let her breasts intoxicate you, be captivated by her love. It doesn't matter the changes that will happen, because those changes will happen. And that's why when I counsel people, I remind them to factor in the changes that will come. You need to be ready to adapt to the changes that come in marriage. We will not look the same way we did years ago when we got married. We will not think the same way because we're evolving. And so if you're single and you're considering getting married to a particular person, you need to think about it. Are you willing to accommodate the changes that will come along the way? The way they will change, their thought pattern will change, they will improve, they will evolve, they will, you know, have new experiences, and you have to grow with it and accept these experiences as time passes. And so this father advises his son to be satisfied, find, you know, be intoxicated by her love, let her breasts satisfy you. So today I want you to think about this scripture, and maybe your love life or your sexual intimacy has been cold. If you rate it, maybe it's 1 out of 5. You need to step it up. you need to enjoy this part of your relationship. This is the fun part of it. It's like the icing on the cake. I know some people don't eat icing, but the icing on the cake, you know, increases the sweetness or the excitement about the cake. All right, Jimmy Evans said, if there's no sex in marriage, it takes out the fun and it just becomes like a business transaction, just the boring routines of every day. But sex adds fun and causes you to, you know, connect on a different level than you would with anyone else. And so today, remember that God wants you to enjoy each other. He wants you to enjoy lovemaking. It's a gift that He has given to us. Sex is a gift from God to us in marriage, and you are free to enjoy it. God sanctions it. You know, He put a stamp on it. Hallelujah. So today, as you meditate upon this proverb, what is God's wisdom to you? Think about it. Where are you in this area of your marriage? And do the needful. I hope that this was helpful to you. Please, as always, share the video, like, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe to this channel. And I'll see you again in the next video. God bless you.